The partisan showdown over the U.S. debt ceiling continues. Senate Democrats called off an early afternoon vote on the debt limit on Wednesday after the chamber's top Republican floated a plan that would buy more time to resolve the issue. Republican Senator Mitch McConnell said his party would support an extension of the federal debt ceiling into December. McConnell's offer could provide an off-ramp to a months-long standoff between the two parties. U.S. President Joe Biden piling the pressure on senators to act quickly. He says raising the borrowing cap is about paying for what the U.S. owes.
My Republican friends need to stop playing Russian roulette with the U.S. economy. If they don't want to do the job, just get out of the way. We'll take the heat. We'll do it. Now Republicans won't raise the debt limit despite being responsible for what the debt limit, why it has to be raised, for the bills that are outstanding. They won't raise it enough through, if done, we're going to be defaulting on a debt that would lead to self-inflicted wounds that risk the market tanking and wiping out retirement savings and costing jobs.
A U.S. debt default would severely hurt the country's credit rating, plunge the global financial system into turmoil, and pose a major risk to companies' stock prices. A high-stakes meeting between the U.S. and China reportedly in the works. A senior U.S. administration official says President Joe Biden and his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping could hold a virtual meeting before the year ends as the two world powers agreed to bring relations back on track. The year-end meeting would be a follow-on from the September 9 phone call between the two leaders. The announcement comes after a meeting between senior American and Chinese officials in Zurich, Switzerland. During that meeting, the White House raised concerns about contentious issues, including Beijing's actions in the South China Sea. China, meanwhile, urged the U.S. to respect its sovereignty. But both sides said the talks, which lasted for 6 hours, were constructive and candid. A look now at the financial markets. Wall Street ending higher on Wednesday as investors grew more optimistic. Congressional Democrats and Republicans could reach a deal to avert a government debt default. The Dow adding over 100 points, while the S&P 500 gained 0.4%. The tech-heavy Nasdaq also climbing nearly 0.5% as tech shares rose after the U.S. Treasury yield retreated from three-month highs. Stocks were lower for much of the session after a strong showing of private jobs in September fueled bets the U.S. Federal Reserve could start reining in monetary stimulus soon. The ADP National Employment Report showed private payrolls increased by 568,000 jobs last month, better than the 428,000 forecast. The more comprehensive non-farm payrolls data is due on Friday, which is expected to cement the case for the Fed's slowing of asset purchases.
Well, we are certainly late stage in the bull market here. I mean, we've seen the big recovery from COVID, and now, you know, with the Delta variant, you know, there's a lot of uncertainty, though, because the economy is late stage in its cycle. There's talk of tapering and how that's going to all play out. There's uncertainty also on the political front with both this infrastructure bill as well as the social spending bill that the Biden administration is looking to pass. And with that, all at the same time, you're seeing inflation.
Taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, all the major indices pointing to a higher open when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, over here in Asia, let's see how markets are doing. So far, shares are trading higher after the progress on the U.S. debt ceiling impasse lifted Wall Street overnight. South Korea's Kospi Index so far leading the gains, up 0.8%, while markets in Japan and Australia are also in the green. Meanwhile, markets in China still closed for the Golden Week holiday.